Time travel has often been a topic of science fiction, but when brought into the conversation about real possibilities, the concept is often left by the wayside. But not all scientists believe it to be just another made-up plot device for the world of sci-fi. Perhaps it isn't so far-fetched after all. In this sci-fi, we look at five signs that time travel is real. Number 5, black holes as time machines. While writing his 1986 novel Contact, Carl Sagan reached out to a scientist by the name of Kip Thorne to discuss the possibility of using a black hole as a way to travel through time. Sagan's idea inspired Kip to research this on a more scientific level. He brought on physicist Sung-Won Kim, and the two of them looked back to a theory first thought up in 1963 by New Zealand mathematician Roy Kerr. Kerr used field equations to analyze a rotating black hole, also known as a Kerr black hole. Now, to understand the significance of a rotating black hole, we have to go back even further to 1949, when the mathematician and colleague and friend of Albert Einstein, Kurt Gödel, discovered that equations showed time travel is in fact possible if only the universe were rotating. Gödel's research showed that a rotating universe could even function as a time machine itself, as it would allow for closed time-like curves. A closed time-like curve would create a path where one could travel through time in a non-linear manner, or, in other words, time travel. Unfortunately, the universe as far as we know is not rotating. The idea didn't seem to go anywhere, but let's jump back forward and connect these dots. Kip Thorne and Sung-Won Kim realized that a rotating black hole, or a Kerr black hole, could very well be the exact thing that was missing from Kurt Gödel's original idea for creating closed time-like curves. The rotating Kerr black hole could serve as a replacement for the rotating universe. Thorne decided that, in theory, if we were able to create a wormhole, we would be able to use it alongside a rotating black hole to connect it to another point in space, as long as it was held in place by some form of negative energy, thus creating a time machine of sorts. This clearly isn't a hard equation that could be applied today and a machine could be developed. It would take lots more sussing out and research. But the theory stands, and if we had the means, it's possible that this could be a major stepping stone on the path to a time machine's invention. Number 4, the block universe theory. In this theory, the block which represents our universe has four dimensions, three of which are spatial, meaning length, width, and height, but the fourth dimension is time. Picture a cube. Now, imagine all of space-time fits nicely within that cube, all four dimensions. Time in this case would be represented, for purely visual understanding, as the width between the front and the back of the box. At one side of this cube, we would have the Big Bang. On the opposite side, we would have the end of time, whatever that looks like. Our present time is bunched up nicely in there, hopefully not too close to the end side. This cube holding all of space and time would exist in a sort of static motion. Everything that has happened, is happening, and will happen, has already happened and will always be just as it is in that nicely organized cube. Now, let's simplify that just a bit. Think of time as a book, a novel in this case. That story is printed out and remains in its entirety exactly as it always will be. It doesn't change, but we can still go through and observe it as though we are experiencing the events within it for the first time. The block theory suggests that this is essentially what we are doing with time. We are going through and observing, but the idea that it is happening in front of us is actually more of an illusion. So, where does time travel come in? If we accept that time is more of an observable illusion, then in theory, we would be able to observe it at other points rather than just what we call present. Unfortunately, in this theory, nothing is changeable, not even the future. Tomorrow, you will wake up and do exactly what you already have in space-time, just as yesterday you did whatever you did that led you here, in the present, watching this video. This would mean we can observe but not alter. That's not to say that you cannot travel back in time and impact it, it just means that if you have gone back in time, then it has already happened, and the effects of such an event have already played out. This of course means that no time traveler has ever gone back and saved JFK or prevented the Holocaust. But it doesn't mean that someone from the future didn't go back and make either of those events occur. In short, it doesn't mean time travelers haven't been to the past, it just means that whatever they may have done has already impacted our present. But in the next segment, we're going to slightly contradict this idea. Number 3. Stephen Hawking says it's possible. In Stephen Hawking's lecture, Time and Space Warps, Hawking goes back to Einstein's notion that time travel would be pretty well impossible, as there would be a need for an infinite amount of energy, as time travel would mean traveling faster than the speed of light. Now, the specific science is out of my capability to describe in a list form at YouTube, but in short, he states that due to evidence that it is scientifically possible to bend light, and due to something called the Casimir effect, which proves we can warp space-time in a negative direction, it would in fact be possible to use this to create technology that would literally create a wormhole, or perhaps warp time and space in some other form, to create an opening to a different time. But here's where things get tricky. As some of you may know, Hawking famously hosted a party for time travelers in which he invited time travelers to attend. Of course, no one showed up, or there would have been quite a lot more fuss over the whole thing. So if time travel does exist, where are all the time travelers? Hawking has two answers for why this may be. The first is that there may be such a thing as alternate histories. The history in which we have lived is set in stone and it cannot be altered. So as we travel time, instead of going back into the past of our history, we go back into another one. This riffs on the idea of parallel universes, which Hawking has also had lots to say about. I won't go into that here, but if you are interested in this, I will direct you to my video, Are We Living in a Parallel Universe? The second reason there may be no time travelers is that we may not be able to visit our past. As he said in the alternate histories theory, our past may be set in stone and unchangeable. Essentially, we will only be able to travel through the time we have not yet observed, which unfortunately means yes, we may only be able to travel into the future. To finish off here, another interesting thing Hawking suggested in the lecture was the possibility that the universe was somehow enforcing the laws of time, meaning it may be fixing itself to not allow for time travel, even though it may be possible. As often discussed, time travel would be very complicated when it comes to paradoxes. The practice may make the universe too unstable. It may literally not be able to handle it. This he calls the chronology protection law. Because of the unsureness of what time travel may do to our universe, Hawking says he hopes that there really is such a thing. But he ends his lecture off with an optimistic cue for time travel enthusiasts. There's hope in string theory. Number 2. A reporter slips through time. Science is great, and if you're like me, it holds all the importance of how you perceive and understand the world. But sometimes, it's important to accept that even with all of our massive discoveries and research, we really only understand a tiny fraction of why the universe works the way it does. In this segment, we're going to jump away from trying to comprehend something we probably will never understand completely, and instead focus on the unexplainable stories that may prove time travel is already happening in the universe, and we may not even be the ones causing it to occur. There are plenty of urban legends and different stories. I'm sure many of you have heard of John Titor, or the man that met his future self. Perhaps if you're interested, I can do a video on some of those more popular stories, but in this case, I have chosen a lesser-known story that I find equally fascinating. The story takes place in the present time of 1932. A newspaper reporter by the name of J. Bernard Hutton and photographer Joachim Brandt were sent to do a story on Germany's Hamburg shipyard. The assignment had gone just as planned and nothing out of the ordinary had taken place, but that normalcy came to an end just as they were set to leave. The two suddenly heard incredibly loud aircraft engines and saw the sky randomly filled with fighter planes. The planes released bombs and the site quickly became a terrifying war zone. Hutton apparently asked a security guard if there was anything he could do, but he was instead rushed off the premise. This is where things get even stranger. After they had begun to leave, the sky suddenly cleared up once more. There was no smoke, there were no loud noises, it was as if nothing had ever occurred. Their newspaper office didn't believe a word they said, and the story just stuck between the two of them. Even the pictures Brandt took portrayed a nice, clean, uneventful shipyard. Fast forward 11 years. Bernard was at this time living in London, 1943. This is where he read in the papers of the devastating air raid by the Royal Air Force Squadron on the Hamburg shipyard. It had happened just as he remembered it 11 years prior. Is it possible that he and Brandt unknowingly slipped through a hole in time? Did they experience the future before it happened? Whether or not this specific story is true, there are countless others that present the same idea. Someone accidentally slipped through time and has no understanding of what happened. So could it be possible that there are holes through time randomly throughout the universe? This would perhaps explain many unexplainable incidents. What do you think? Number 1. Cosmic strings. Cosmic strings are a hypothetical topological defect in the universe. Strings were first theorized in 1991 by a physicist by the name of J. Richard Gott. Gott explains that, if real, they would have been formed during the early universe. They are described as incredibly thin, string-like structures that stretch across the universe. These strings would be thinner than an atom, therefore they would be under an immense amount of pressure. Because of this, they would create an incredibly strong gravitational pull on anything around them. In theory, that would mean if anything like, say, a spaceship was able to get close to one, it could essentially use that gravity to hitch a ride along the string and travel incredibly fast through the universe. As we know, according to the theory of relativity, traveling at incredible speeds submits you to the effects of time dilation. Time dilation is when one experiences time different to another observer, either due to a velocity difference relative to each other, or by being differently situated relative to a gravitational field. But this isn't where the idea ends. It is theorized that if we were somehow able to pull two of these strings together, we would be able to warp time enough to create a closed time-like curve. With this, it may be possible for a spaceship or a time machine to shoot itself backwards into time. Of course, with this theory, you wouldn't be able to travel back to before the time machine was created, and we're not sure these strings even exist, but remember that this idea first came to be in 1991. Stephen Hawking's famous Hawking radiation prediction wasn't proven until about 40 years after it was first theorized. Thanks for checking out this sci-fi. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out my last video, 5 Incredible Facts About Human Genetics, and be sure to stay tuned for future sci-fis on all things science and science fiction.